Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarans on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 3, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday. First article of interest, Baghdad operations confirm the lifting of the curfew. November 16, 2019 1618 Baghdad. The curfew will be lifted completely within days. Al-Mohammadawi said in a speech with a crowd of demonstrators, "Your voice has reached the whole world, and that the security forces are to protect you," stressing the importance of maintaining peaceful demonstration, and not to approach the security barriers, and that the demonstration in the place in cooperation with the forces' security through news about the engineers and saboteurs who seek to distort the demonstrations about its peaceful march. He explained that curfew has been eased so that citizens can return to their homes, noting that the curfew will be lifted in the coming days. Next article of interest. The threshold of Husseini republished a previous reference sermon in which he warned what Iraq is going through today. November 3, 2019 1523 Baghdad. The official website of the Holy Shrine of Husseini published a warning issued by the highest religious authority earlier in the country to enter a cycle of instability because of the preoccupation of the political class conflicts and disputes and differences on sites and positions. The text of the last recommendation in the Friday prayer sermon of Sheikh Abdul-Mahdi Karbalai dated March 15, 2019, A.D., that the preoccupation of the political class with conflicts and tensions and differences over positions and positions has entered the country in a cycle of instability and underdevelopment of the rest of the peoples in waste of energy and psychological crisis of the citizen in addition to the loss of opportunities to provide services to citizens and provide job opportunities and development for him, and it is time to wake up from our inattention and dismantle our families to our ambitions and aspirations and to take from the experiences of the past and the suffering of the present and the hopes of the future lessons and preaching to what we should do towards our people and our country. It is worth mentioning that the highest religious authority during the Friday prayer sermon last Friday called on all parties inside Iraq to reflect on the present and future of Iraq away from emotions and special interests. "We appeal to all parties to reflect on the present and future of Iraq," said the statement read by its representative, Ahmed Al-Safi. Next article of interest. Blocking roads leading to oil fields in Meissen. 3 November, 2019 Baghdad. On Sunday, demonstrators blocked the road leading to the Al-Bayzerkan oil field, the Meissen oil refinery and the Al-Shaib border port in Meissen. A source familiar with the information, the demonstrators proceeded to cut off the road leading to the Bayzerkan oil field and Meissen oil refinery and the outlet Al-Shaib border in Meissen district of the morgue. The source added that a state of confusion and chaos in the roads leading to those sites, while patrols arrived from the police to secure the demonstrators. Next article of interest, who should be the biggest question in Iraq? 3 November, 2019 by Muslim Abbas. There is one central question in Iraq. Are we turning the table on the entire political system or doing gradual reforms for fear of things out of control? It is not easy to present a recipe for such a question. The demonstrations that started in Iraq from 2011 until the last October demonstrations did not resolve the controversy. Writers and prudent opininers presented different visions but did not reach the final answer. The protests at the beginning were based on simple demands: reform of some of the joints of the Iraqi state, a simple reforms at the time, most notably the solution of the crisis of services and the end of the electricity file. But the government has been unable to respond to the demands of the demonstrators since then and so far, and with each season of demonstrations increased demands and the ceiling of reform, to move closer to the roots of the ruling political system. With every previous demonstration, the idea of uprooting the regime was on the table, but it was not strong enough to move far to achieve this goal, because the demonstrations themselves were looking for supporters and looking for legitimacy for their existence because the regime was new and despite its mistakes in that period. But it was not the forces so great that you bring down the regime. The security situation was the biggest concern of the people, and the demand to uproot the regime was similar to standing up to the current and a kind of political luxury that the citizen does not care about, nor desires at all. But turning the page of the security file actually by the end of the war on ISIS, and the beginning of the era of the civil state by opening the streets, lifting security controls and concrete blocks and stopping terrorist bombings years ago, the citizen has actually been thinking about things of political luxury, most notably the idea of regime change. Before answering the possibility of regime change, we should ask the following question: why do people want to change a system that they have elected themselves? Because the people found that their voice does not reach those who despise, and that there is an official theft of his electoral vote and then accuses the citizen that he did this act. The process of theft starts from the electoral system itself, controversial, represented by the law of street, lego, which was subjected to the process of amendment according to the requirements of interests partisanship, and the interests of the parties holding power, which helps to take the votes of political blocs obtained a certain percentage of votes in favor of large political blocs. After the electoral law, the second robbery comes through the use of political money to buy votes, through the burning of election funds and a campaign of mutual accusations of electoral fraud. A large section of the people who did not participate in the elections were watching the electoral situation, and their vengeance increases with no way out of reform. Party, what is left to change then? With this bad electoral reality, there was a worsening service reality, accompanied by a near-total absence of employment opportunities for young university graduates and others, and in general the people's view of the country is going to the abyss. Between the meeting of the unfair electoral system, the unfair division of wealth, services and opportunities work, it is necessary to think of uprooting the regime at its roots in order to preserve the existence of the Iraqi state, because the political rust is spreading at a tremendous speed, and the people only have to say their word. But the uprooting of the regime is not a tourist trip, nor is it a popular demonstration that raises some romantic slogans. Radical change means destroying the roof and preparing for the process of lifting the rubble and waiting for a certain period before the reconstruction process starts from scratch, and regional and international waiting for this moment to take the rest of the Iraqi state. And if we take into account that there are constitutional institutions and there are legal facilities exist, no matter how corrupt the system, and therefore the best option is to repair the parts that have suffered political rust and not the whole ship, because the cops end corrupt. An angry protester asks, how can we achieve gradual reform when we have tried this in previous years and did not achieve any of this? Here is a pivotal question. The political blocs play today on the factor of time. They wanted to keep the system as strong hen. They proved the usefulness of a system for the people, in order to overcome the current crisis and achieve the interest of the country without demolishing the ceiling. Everyone must the ruling political class to agree and implement urgently the following files: 1. Adopt a fair electoral law. 2. Forming an independent electoral commission and working in cooperation with the judiciary and without any interference from political parties. 3. The equitable distribution of wealth among citizens and the elimination of class differences, especially the privileges of politicians. 4. Providing services to the citizen to achieve a comfortable atmosphere and not randomness in the implementation of projects. The people aspire to a developed country as expressed by the slogans of the demonstrators. 5. Providing job opportunities for young people, not by involving them in government jobs, but by opening factories and strategic projects that absorb young people first and represent an added value to the economy. 6. Effective implementation of the Constitution in all its clauses and cessation of legal selectivity, because that feels that the citizen is protected from a higher authority than the authority of the parties, which is the law. 7. Establish an economic system that operates with a dynamic self-reliance away from dependence on oil to reassure the current generation of its future and the independence of the next generation. Next article of interest: Prime Minister's Office, delayed discussion of the 2020 budget due to include the demands of the demonstrators. 3rd November, 2019, Baghdad, the media office of the Prime Minister attributed on Sunday the delay in discussing the 2020 budget in the council to include paragraphs concerning the demands of the demonstrators and the preparation of financial doors. The cabinet, in cooperation with the concerned authorities in the General Secretariat and the Ministry of Finance, is working to include the demands of the demonstrators with the financial aspect to be included in the 2020 budget, Information Office spokesman William Warda said. He added that the process of listing the demands behind the delayed discussion in the Council of Ministers and vote on them for the purpose of sending them to the House of Representatives to vote on them. He explained that most of the demands in the reform packages that need a parliamentary vote have ensured the draft budget. Next article of interest: MP warns political class not to waste last chance. November 3, 2019, 1614, Baghdad, where MP of the Victory Coalition Adnan Zarfi, Sunday, that the political class is about to waste what he called the last chance, indicating that the youth is the rule of the people at the moment. It is time for the political class in Iraq not to repeat the mistake of the past, Zarfi said in a tweet on his Twitter account. They admitted today that the ruler of this people is the youth. Do not ignore them. You are about to miss the last chance. The Zarfi said in an earlier tweet, refusing to use all methods of violence against those who care about the demonstrators, adding that their defense and to demand accountability for the perpetrators of the shedding of their blood is a sign the national cannot be reversed. The witness of the capital Baghdad and other cities to protest demonstrations going on since the 25th of the month the past, demanding change of government and fighting corruption. Next article of interest. Foreign Ministry confirms opening the door to investment for Cypriot companies to support the Iraqi economy. 3rd November 2019, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs on Sunday called on Cypriot companies to participate in supporting the Iraqi economy through investment in the country, noting the need to increase diplomatic representation between the two parties. In a statement received by the ministry said that Foreign Minister Mohammed Ali Al-Hakim received a copy of the credentials of the non-resident ambassador to Cyprus, Andreas Kospis. He called on Minister Hakim to raise the diplomatic representation between the two countries, stressing Iraq IXO establish the best relations and openness to all countries of the world. He stressed the need for cooperation between the two countries to achieve common interests and to prevent common risks, stressing the importance of upgrading the prospects of bilateral cooperation in all fields. The minister pointed out that the doors of investment in Iraq open to Cypriot companies to work and support the economic sector. Next article of interest. Iranian mediation between two blocs to choose a quick alternative to Abdul-Mahdi. 3rd November 2019, parliamentary sources revealed the existence of Iranian mediation between the leaders of political blocs, specifically Maqada al-Sadr and Hadi al-Amiri, in order to get out of the current crisis with the least losses, according to an official. The mediation could be through Adel Abdul-Mahdi resigning and agreeing on an alternative prime minister quickly, while proceeding with the pledges announced later by the three presidencies, the officials said. He pointed out that Iran is seeing in the Iraqi demonstrations an impact on the Iranian interior, especially after anti-Iranian slogans and the burning of pictures of the Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei and the commander of the Iranian Quds Force, Qasem Soleimani, in Karbala, Najaf, Baghdad and Meissen by the demonstrators. Tehran is trying to broker a truce, even if it is at the expense of changing the government of Abdul-Mahdi, which is considered more voluntarily than any previous government, according to the official. He continued, there are many contacts in the Iranian mediation file, adding that the suppression of demonstrations may open the door of international intervention and Iraq does not want anyone, especially Iran, so the mediation is based on persuading Sadr to refrain from supporting the demonstrations and change the current government. He pointed out that this week will be crucial in the scene if the demonstrations continue. Next article of interest. Iraqi government issues first comment on Abdul-Mahdi's presence in parliament. 3rd November 2019, government spokesman Saad al-Hadithi said on Sunday the reason for the absence of Prime Minister Adel Abdul-Mahdi to the Iraqi parliament. Al-Hadithi told Shafak News that the presence of Prime Minister Adel Abdul-Mahdi in the House of Representatives is linked to the establishment of a clear mechanism. Ministers to clarify that policy, he explained that the other mechanism is an interrogation session, which is the request of a deputy with the consent of 25 other deputies. A request is made and a date is set, between the presidency of the parliament and the prime minister, to agree on a specific date to attend. He stressed that the prime minister, in principle, does not have any problem in coming before the House of Representatives and clarify the position of the government on the vital files, and at the same time the prime minister respects the constitutional mechanisms provided for in the constitution. The legislative authority has the right to clarify the policy of the government. He added that but there are specific mechanisms must be agreed upon to submit a request for the presence of the prime minister or any of the ministers to the House of Representatives, a hearing or a questioning session, and this has not yet been determined. The government spokesman said that Abdul-Mahdi, whenever that mechanism is available and agreed on the date of attendance in coordination between the presidency of the parliament and the prime minister, he does not have any problem of attending the parliament. The Iraqi Council of Representatives voted in Tuesday's meeting to host Prime Minister Adel Abdul-Mahdi and keep the meeting open until his presence. This came in the wake of ongoing protests in Iraq since the 25th of last month, which left dozens of dead and thousands wounded. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like subscribe button and check out the CEP Currency Exchange Planner. The link is in the description panel. Make sure to tell them the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.